So I want to read out of 1 Peter chapter 1 this morning, and I want us to make some declarations out of it, okay? So it says, "Celebrate with praise the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has shown us his extravagant mercy." That's the first line here. So let's turn that into a declaration. I celebrate with praises, my God and Father of my Lord Jesus Christ, who has shown me his extravagant mercy. His fountain of mercy has given me a new life. I'm reborn. I am reborn to experience a living, energetic hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ. His resurrection is my resurrection. I am reborn into a perfect inheritance that will never perish, that will never be defiled, and it will never diminish. It is promised and preserved forever in the heavenly realm for me. Through my faith, the mighty power of God constantly guards me until my full salvation is ready to be revealed in the last time. May the thought of this cause, may the thought of this cause me to jump for joy.
Jump for joy!
Even though sometimes I've had to put up with grief and many trials. Do you guys catch this? We jump for joy when there's a trial. We jump for joy when there's grief. Because these only reveal the sterling core of my faith, which is far more valuable than any gold or silver that perishes. I am refined by fire like gold. My authentic faith will result in even more praise, even more glory, and even more honor as Jesus is revealed through me. I love God passionately.
Love God passionately.
Even when it feels like I can't see Him.
Even when it feels like I can't see Him.
Through believing in Him,
I'm
saturated with ecstatic joy.
I'm exasperated with ecstatic joy.
Indescribably sublime. And immersed in glory. For I am reaping the harvest of my faith. Full salvation is promised to me. My soul is victorious today. You can read the Bible like that, where you just change it into a declaration instead of just reading through it, because the enemy will start to whisper sometimes, "Oh, that was for them. It's not really for you. That's not really true for you. That's not really..." And that's just a bunch of garbage. We get to actually, it says the Word of God is alive and active for us in this moment. That means it's there to cut to the very core of what's going on in our life. And so we can take and we can read scripture that way, where we get to declare who God is, who we are, and what's going to happen. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. At your name, the mountains shake and crumble. Ocean's roar tumble. Sing it again, at your name. No other name but yours. Thank you, Jesus. There is power.
Spirit, you're all we need.
are my anchor, and you never fail. You are my hope, you will deliver, Emmanuel. You are my strength, you are my anchor, and you never fail. You are my hope, you will deliver, Emmanuel.
You alone are worthy.
just praise you. Jesus, I just praise your holy name. You're the name above every other name. You alone are worthy. You alone are blessed and magnified. I just praise your holy name, Jesus. I just praise your holy name. I just praise your holy name. I just praise your holy name.
Born again, fresh and new, with a new heart and
and transformed mind. So we just give you all honor and praise right now, Jesus, and we thank you that your resurrection is our resurrection and your life is our life. And we worship you. We celebrate the life that you give us today. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Spirit this morning is just wanting us to take with us a confidence. Confidence. We prayed over Samantha yesterday and she goes in for surgery tomorrow, and I've heard of some people that are just going through some struggling times and have lost housing and some different situations, and so the Holy Spirit is wanting us to walk out in this place of confidence today. Confident in his goodness, not necessarily confident in our own ability, but in Amen. His ability Amen. To do what he's going to do in us and through us.
Yeah.
It's not us having to strive and push, it's us trusting God
right.
to do it. Whether it be a financial thing or a health thing, I appreciated what Haley was singing at the beginning of finish what he started.
Yeah.
It's a promise of God that He watches after his word to perform it, to perfect it, that his promises are yes and amen, they're true, and that he promises to start the work, or to finish the work that he started in us.
Amen.
To finish the work. So when we face something that that feels so hard, we have to remind ourselves and almost convince our feelings. We have to convince our flesh, hey, great are you, Lord.
Yeah. Yes.
God is faithful, and I am confident. I have hope in him. I have full trust in his faithfulness.
Yeah.
And then we go back to remind ourselves of what he's done. So I just released that faith this morning to remind ourselves of what he's done, and knowing that that's just a picture of what's still to come. And that he's providing and he's showing us greater things. Great are you, Lord. I want to remind everybody there will not be worship here tomorrow morning, because we're going to be in Salem leading David's tent, Tent America, that starts this evening. What you can do is go to our Facebook page at Faith Foundry. We will be going live during the worship time, so you can connect at that time, just on your smartphone or whatever, and have your own worship service. Join us in prayer. You can participate. You don't have to be in Salem to participate with what we're doing. This is happening across the nation for today through Saturday. Every state in this nation is lifting up worship and praise and gospel proclamation in multiple locations. So the latest update is now that Oregon has six tents that are going to be across this state that are lifting up 50 hours, continual worship and intercessory prayer over our state and our nation, and gospel proclamation, where the gospel is going to be out in the marketplace, proclaimed out in the streets, and people will be saved, people will be healed and delivered. Every year that Holly and I have been doing this for 6 years, every year we have seen people come to Christ, we've seen miracle healings, and we've seen our state change. We've seen things shift in the atmosphere.
Yes.
We watched it happen at DC last year, where for the last 15 years or so, they have not gone one day without at least five to seven, like murders or terrible crimes, violent crimes. Thank you. Violent crimes. When we began to lift up worship and praise on the National Mall with tens of thousands of people, all violent crimes stopped for the whole weekend.
Amen.
They have never gone one day in 15 years without violent crime. And all violent crimes stopped as we lifted up the song of the Lord and as we proclaimed the goodness. So we're shifting the atmosphere in our state. We're shifting the atmosphere in our nation through our praise. Amen? Through our prayers. So join us in prayer. Join us in praise. Worship along. All you have to do to look up, you can look up. There's going to be live events all the time over the next 3 days. You can go on to Facebook and just type in Tent America or Awaken the Dawn. And there will be all sorts of different live feeds that you can connect with across the nation. They actually started some last night. So that's what we're going up to do. Tomorrow you can tune in, Faith Foundry, at our normal time, although I think we're starting at 6 a.m. We're going to be worshiping from 6 a.m. to 10 a.m. And so you guys can join us during that time. It doesn't have to just be from 8 to 9. So let's stand and bless each other today. If you have an offering that you want to bring to the Lord, if you want to sow a seed into what we're doing, we appreciate your heart to give. But more than that, it's an opportunity to partner with the Lord. We have buckets up front that gives you an opportunity to say, God, I'm trusting in you in a new way. I'm sowing into your kingdom. I'm planting a seed so that a harvest comes to me. And I just didn't want to leave it, today without giving you that opportunity to sow into the kingdom of God. Let's bless each other. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord smile down on you and show you his kindness. May the Lord answer your prayers and give you his peace. May the Lord cover you with his name. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Amen. Also tonight, 6:30, celebrate recovery. Carla's going to bring a word tonight, so you don't want to miss that.
All right.
Have a blessed day.
So ladies, I'm going to
give you guys a ride home.
Ride of their life.
Hello.